A question that's bugged me way too long is what this white thing looking at this tube of Go-Gurt is. I composited the tube of Go-Gurt in for just a... But hey, you might be saying, Max, that's a boo. Yeah, I know it's a boo, but what is a boo? According to a story I found written on a napkin slipped in my Hyrule Historia, they were famously invented by Sugar Daddy Miyamoto when he was jerking off to a calculator in a bus, but his wife walked in and he had to pretend he had written booze instead of boobs on it, and was inventing a new character which he then drew on his testicle that he'd been clenching in his fist. Now, for the longest time, folks thought boos were just normal ghosts, just cute ghosts, just what happens to Marios and Toads and Bowsers and Koopas when they die. In Paper Mario, if you use Goombario's tattle ability on Igor, the boo that runs the shop at Boo's Mansion, he mentions that maybe he was a merchant before he became a boo, implying a past life. But then Super Mario World introduced Eeries, which were the ghosts of Yoshi's, and Luigi's Mansion clearly has the ghosts of what were once people. It makes you wonder, what are boos the ghosts of? What else in the Nintendo universe is just a little ball with flappy hands? That's right. Kirby, bro. Is Kirby from a race of puffballs that experienced a mass extinction? They even have a king of their people. There's the King Boo. Was he the King Kirby, but then DDD usurped him and murdered all the Kirbys in a genocide? Using projection technology, we can visualize what the Boos looked like before they died and imagine how they were all wiped out. Okay, oh God, that's incredible. The only reason Kirby survives is because he's a stunted runt of his race. Very small, stubby legs. So there must have been a very big saw that cut off all their legs, and that's why they're floating and they're dead. The end.